Hi there, I'm Jake Billing. Today we're going to set up a Windows 10 domain controller in Hyper-V, and we're going to also install a Windows 10 client and then join that to the domain. Okay, so let's go ahead and launch Hyper-V. In here you need to create a new virtual switch. Okay, so you need to make an internal switch away from your network as it is, simply because your network will already have a router, and that also runs usually DHCP, so you don't want two to conflict on that, and DNS also as well. So go ahead and create an internal network, and then you're done there. Go ahead and make a new virtual machine, and we'll call it Windows Server 10, something like that. Click next, generation 2, because it's above Windows 8. I'm going to assign it 2 GB of RAM, because you can use the SSD as virtual memory for this as well. So then select your internal network that you've created, and then we want to create a new hard drive, give it 80 GB. I'm running on 2 SSDs here, so in RAID 0, so it should be really fast. Okay, go ahead and select your server image here. We've also got Windows 7, Windows 8.1, and Windows 10 client. So open, click next, finish. Let's boot that virtual machine up now with Server 10 running on that. So start it, minimize this out of the way, give this a bit more space, so you can see what we're doing here. Okay, so let's start from that image. This process should take no longer virtually than 5 minutes to set up, and I'm not kidding on that either. SSDs are the way forward, so let's go ahead and do that. You want a server with a graphical user interface, click next. Yeah, accept the terms and the EULA. Create a partition on your unallocated drive. And finish. Okay, this will take literally a minute or so just to install, so I'll pause this and come back in a second. Okay, as you can see, we're more or less there. It took about a minute. It's going to ask us now for an initial administrator secure password, domain controller password, or domain password rather. So let's go ahead. Oh, Jakey. Jakey's lost it today. He's trying to type the wrong password. There we go. I'll log that in now. So the first thing you want to do is just change the name of the server. So it'll take us in a second to the server manager and the server management console. We want to change the name of this server to something recognizable on a domain, because ultimately your clients need to know what the name of the machine is. Okay, so let's log in for the first time. We want to change the computer's name first of all. So in Server Manager, it will load up in a second. Okay, local server, change the server's name. I'm going to call it Server DC1, because it's the first domain controller on this network. Click OK on that, it'll ask us to restart the machine now. Okay, it boots back up again. Okay, the next thing I did was I plonked it on a static IP address, on a Class C address range, and I basically gave it the second address in my virtual network, so number 2. Number 1 would be your internet router, and obviously your DNS server would be this server, because it's going to run DNS. So go ahead and apply that, click OK. Next thing you want to do is add DHCP and DNS together, because your server will need those to operate correctly. So add roles and features here in the server manager, click next, go through, go ahead, and you'll have DHCP, add features, DNS, add features. You'll want to configure DNS after you've promoted the domain controller, but DHCP needs to be done first. So let's go ahead and click next, and install. Okay, so I'll launch DHCP, and I've created my scope of IP addresses that are given out for distribution. So It's a 192 range, so I've assigned them, if you look on here, so the address pool starts from 10 and up to 244. The addresses before that will be assigned statically for servers, for instance, or whatever. So any computer joined to this network now will then pick up an IP address between 192.168.0.10 and 244. Okay, you want to install Active Directory Domain Services next, so next. And that's it, just install that. Okay, done. Okay, you want to then promote this server to a domain controller. If this domain controller was being added to an existing forest, you'd select that one there. But because this is a new domain controller in a new forest, you'd obviously have to create a root domain name. So we're going to call it, let's just use contoso.com, as the Microsoft guys would do. Contoso.com, next. It'll look online, but it can't because there's no internet, because it's a local private network. See if we can find another contoso.com out there, which it would do in reality. Okay, so the forest functional level is as it suggests. The oldest version of Windows Server in your network is selected, so obviously at the moment it's this. Select your password. I always set it to be the same as my domain administrator password, but it's up to you. Next on that. And then this is a good thing to see, because obviously DNS isn't been configured yet at all for this server, because there's no other domain controllers with DNS running. Okay, NetBIOS name, Contoso. So clients can join the domain by typing in Contoso. Click next. Okay, your log files, sysvol and database need to be stored elsewhere, ideally on another server or another drive, so that if you lost it, you can restore it and carry on as normal. So let's continue next and next, and then want to finish this in a second, but a prerequisite check now to check if things okay. As long as there's no red, it'll be fine. Okay, as you can see, all the requisites pass successfully install. Let's go ahead and do that now. Just wait a few seconds for it to finish. Okay, so you need to open DNS. And in forward lookup zones here, if you right click on your Contoso domain entry and click new host day record, if you type in your IP address here and tick this create a pointer box and click add host, that will create the a host record. Okay, next thing we need to do is go to the reverse lookup zone, right click new zone, click next, primary zone, next, all the domain controllers in this forest. IPv4 reverse lookup zone, type in your 192.168.0 into the address field there, click next and add, and that'll be your reverse lookup zone created as well. DNS is done at that point. Okay, the next thing I did was opened up Active Directory users and computers from here, and then created an administrator user called supervisor in a new OU called admin users, and I gave them full administration rights. And okay, so I've just finished setting up a Windows 10 client on this system as well, with Hyper-V. And we're going to go ahead and join this to the domain in a second. Okay, so here we go. The first thing you want to do then, we've checked your client is booted up ready, is go to the command prompt on the computer, and you need to bring up ipconfig. Let's see what IP address we've been given. And as you can see, so it's been assigned 11, as 10 was the first address in the range, it's been given 11. Look at that, fantastic. You can also try and ping the server, so server DC1, should have a response. Yes, we have, under a millisecond to get there and back. And also to check the reverse lookup is working, 192.168.0.2 server address, it can ping all perfectly okay like that. Fantastic. Let's go ahead and join this client to the domain then. So I've just renamed the computer, come up to this PC, properties, and Jake the Beast. Let's go change, and we want to go domain, Contoso. Log in with domain credentials, Contoso slash administrator or supervisor. Let's do supervisor. We know if it's working or not, don't we? Log in with the domain password, and then join the domain. Okay, as you can see, it's showing the domain. It'll ask us to restart the computer now. I just want to point out that we're not going to look at any group policy whatsoever. I just wanted to show Windows 10 joining a domain with the domain user security database in place. There we go, let's log in. So let's log in rather than locally, let's log in as supervisor and then the password. So there we have it, guys. I've logged in as supervisor, as you can see. Like I said, we're not covering group policy at all, but you could deploy applications from that. You could map drives, redirect data, all sorts of things like that. Obviously, lock down and group policy a machine to your taste and whatever you need. I'm just going to show you as well in the server, on the server here in users, in Active Directory, Jake the Beast has obviously been added to the computers list because it's been joined to the domain. And obviously, we can ping each other. Thanks for watching though, guys, and I'll catch you later. See ya!